Maybe you could be a caddy for a professional golfer like me. Would be nice.
Could be nice. I could be fast sometimes.
First question. Why do you run the number 21?
When I was a little kid, I was watching World Superbike races and I was loving the 21 bike with the Troy Bayliss. So when I grew up, I understood also that 21st of April is the born of Rome. Okay. You know? So it's a mix of things and then I decided 21.
Not a bad number then. Good.
Not so bad, yeah. Question for Sam. Which British track that I haven't ridden yet do you think I have to try?
Oh, there's lots of good tracks. I would probably say you've only rode Silverstone now.
Yeah, Miss Silverstone, yes.
Not Donington, never.
Not Donington.
I would say between Donington and Cadel Park.
I was thinking Cadel Park. Yeah.
Maybe not with a MotoGP bike. With maybe. Moto2 can be nice.
Also with motocross, not yet, yeah, no. Because with motocross they're not so good.
But Donington is nice. You would like, yeah? Donington, yeah. Yeah, it's nice.
Cool.
Well, who is your favourite AS Roma player of all time?
The captain, Francesco Dotti, always. Yeah, he's like a big icon in my city, you know? And also, he's a nice guy. When he does the interviews and everything, he's quite nice to listen to.
Good.
For you, which sports athlete is your biggest inspiration?
Okay, it's cliche, but you have to say Rossi, because when I was growing up watching him win races and be at the front with good character and also the way he was winning races, I have to say him, because when you're growing up watching racing, you watch these people, so yeah, Rossi.
Maybe, yeah, it's a good answer.
Yeah. What is the best piece of advice Fausto ever gave you?
When I was 17, I started the World Championship, and the thing that was so true was just enjoy. Enjoy, don't put so much pressure on yourself, just enjoy. And when I was a bit younger than now, I was thinking about it, but not so much. I was just following my instinct and just try to do more and more and more. Yeah. And then I understood that the key is enjoy. When you enjoy, you go much faster, everything is more relaxing.
Also the harder times are less heavy if you're enjoying. Because when you're winning and you're at the front, it's easy to enjoy it. But the difficult times to pass through is...
Yeah, and when you enjoy, it comes everything easier. If you played a pro AM golf tournament, who would you want to play with?
Oh, good question. Of course, as a lot of people know, I love golf. It's something a lot different from racing, but... Probably Rory McIlroy. He's a player that's one of the top in the world,
okay.
And someone I would like to do that
with. We have to go. I never tried, Nate, and we have to organize something.
I'll give
you
a lesson. We'll play for some money. I'll take some off you.
Oh, no, come on, yeah. Come on.
You can only ride at one circuit for the rest of your life. Which do you choose and why?
Oh, that's a tough one.
Mugello? I remember when I was in Moto2, you was in Moto3, we were teammates.
Yeah.
And you told me...
Maybe Mugello.
I think it was your first full year, and you said, I'll wait for Mugello.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, what's this about Mugello? We arrived in Mugello, you finished second or third, I think.
Yeah, 37 milliseconds.
Thought fair play, yeah, he was waiting for Mugello.
Yeah, well, yeah, honestly, yes. Maybe Mugello, because, you know, for an Italian guy, Mugello is something, amazing place.
Yeah, extra, yeah.
And also, with the bigger bike, it's so
cool. Sure, next year will be...
imagine on the top of the street.
Yeah.
Whoa.
It'll be something nice. Yeah.
Amazing. Mugello. What gives you more satisfaction, your own success or your brother's success?
Well, it's a nice question. Obviously, me and my brother are really close.
Yeah.
I'm really proud of him when he gets good results. I hate watching him, but really proud when he does well. But in the end, obviously, it has to be my success because I do it for me. And when you win or do well, is something that is hard to describe. But it's very close, but I have to say mine. If you weren't a Moto2 rider, what job do you think you would have?
Well,
I think it's not possible, Paul, to say in this.
It's difficult. I don't know, maybe something with the sports, for sure.
Yeah, it's what we know in the end.
Yeah, at the end, we know just this, because with the school, it's a bit...
Maybe you could be a caddy for a professional golfer like me. Would be nice.
Could be nice. I could be fast sometimes. Yeah. Sometimes could be fast. Not for position, but I could be fast in the long distance golf. Yeah. Who is one rider on the current MotoGP grid you'd like to be teammates with?
Current MotoGP grid?
Current. Not next year, because next year for sure me.
Yeah. I've been with you and I enjoyed. Jack Miller.
Grande Jack.
Yeah, a great person, great rider and a nice guy, so yeah, Jack Miller.
Yeah, I think he's the one guy maybe that he's enjoying much, you know? So,
yeah, like you say, it's important to enjoy and he does as well. So,
he does it.
How did you celebrate your Spanish GP win?
Well, we tried to party a little bit with my friends, but just at home. And we did a good party, honestly.
It's important
to party, you know?
we
have massive highs, massive lows in this sport, so when you have massive highs, you have to keep the momentum
100%.
For 100%.
The lows come around fast, so it's important to enjoy the good times.
Exactly. Who's got a better chance of winning the Euros, Italy or England?
Hey, it's coming now. I would love to say England, but I probably would say Italy. But I'm not a massive. I love football. I love all sports. I love watching the Euros. I love watching the World Cup. Also, it's nice in between the riders and the teams because different nationalities is really cool. Well, I'll have to say England because you know it has to be. But Italy look really good. The first few games have been well. So,
look good.
Yeah.
So
it's early.
It's early. Exactly.
Right. Talk us through the process of you posting a picture on Instagram, from taking your pictures to choosing it, editing it, and writing your caption. You don't edit, do you?
You don't have
to edit. Look at him, he's beautiful.
Why?
When you're old and dad life like me, you have to edit pictures.
I don't edit this picture, honestly. Well, my hair are still blonde, so it's not an edit, you know, it is just a shit thing that I've done it. But nobody, just me.
Just pick a good picture and post it up, that's it.
Yeah, I like to speak to social people, you know, also trying to inspire somehow the young guys, because I saw that I have a lot of young guys that they follow me.
Yeah.
So I think it's important for us to have this responsibility to try to bring something, you know, to give something good to the young guys.
Use it in a positive way. I agree, it's nice.
This. Your most memorable race to date?
Yeah, it's a good question. I don't know the most memorable race. Maybe Austin. Maybe Austin, when I won in Moto2 for the first time in with Speed Up. Because, you know, when I came from Supersport in the first year, was a little bit more difficult in Moto2, and I didn't know many people in the paddock, and didn't feel like many people gave me much of a chance. So then to win a Grand Prix in America as well, which is a great place, great track. Yeah, this is something that will stay with me for a long time.
That also was a good one. Yeah. Last one for me.
Yeah, last one for Digi. What do you think when you realise the rider behind you in a race is me?
No, maybe.
I don't like to be behind, but...
sometimes.
Definitely. I have no more questions, but...
Thank you
for the chat.
Thank you, mate.
Cheers, DJ.
Hello, YouTube. I'm Björn Mir. If you like this video, don't forget to give us a big thumbs up and subscribe to our channel.